rain down smoke.
Hello everybody and welcome back to a brand new video. My name is Nalo and today we're going to be talking about float capped items and how to invest in them. Before we get to that though, let's go ahead and take a quick look at swap.gg. So yeah, that's going to be swap.gg. They do have PayPal deposits, which is something that a lot of sites don't offer, so it's pretty interesting that they have it. They're completely 100% legit, and you can use my link in the description below if you want to go ahead and check them out and support the channel out a little bit. So with that being said, let's get into this video. Okay, so float-based items. We know that every item in the game has a specific float that determines what kind of wear it actually is going to be in the game, and we know that there's also some interesting weird items from quite a long time ago that actually have float caps. For example, a lot of items from a long time ago were only able to go up to 0.06 in factory new condition, which made the factory new versions of those items a lot more rare. This is why stuff like Karambit Safari Mesh factory news and Fire Serpent factory news are a lot more expensive than other items, because obviously they're a lot more rare to get. There are also some items that are actually capped at field tested. For example, the Op Asimov and the M4A4 Asimov are both capped in field tested condition, and they can only go up to around 0.18 as well, which makes these very low float 0.18 versions of these items quite expensive. But this video isn't showcasing those items, it's specifically talking about them as investment potential. So the reason I want to bring these up is because this is sort of not a practice that CSGO actually undergoes in current times. They don't really release skins that have float caps anymore, and it's kind of the thing that they only used to do in the past. What this means is that these items obviously get more rare by the day because they're not going to be released into more newer float cap versions in the future. Nowadays though, CSGO has actually changed what they decided to do for these items, and instead of making them have a float cap where you can only get a certain float to have that wear, what they've done is just completely remove that wear from the items altogether. So for example, with the P250 Asimov, it can only go up to minimal wear and you cannot get it in factory new condition no matter what you do. The P250 Asimov can also only be obtained in a 0.10 float, which means that you can't get that 0.07 that is usually the float cap for the item. Now you're probably wondering, how exactly does this float cap actually correlate to investments? Well, the main thing here is that these items are not only old, but they also have the float cap itself. Now, interestingly enough, the float cap actually influences how easy it is to get the item from something like a case or from a trade-up. It actually makes it a lot more rare to get the item in these lower wares, which means that the items are actually a lot lower quantity than most other items would be. This is sort of a perfect storm, if you will, because these items are not only good because they are old, but they're also good because they are harder to obtain in these wares, which means that not only is their quantity pretty low, but they're also harder to obtain nowadays simply because they're older and the methods to obtaining them are going to be a lot more expensive, which prices a lot of people out. One problem, of course, with these items is that they are pretty rare, which means that their volume is going to be a lot lower because people aren't going to be selling them all over the place simply because they don't really exist in the highest quantities that they did before. Furthermore, there are older items, which also contributes to the amount of times that people are actually buying them in general, simply because there are newer items to buy, and so these ones are kind of overshadowed. However, for the items that do have float caps, those ones are going to be extremely interesting to pick up, especially the Fire Serpent, and that's the main one that I want to focus on today. The Fire Serpent not only looks very good to a lot of people, although it is sort of a controversial skin today, and the item is also pretty rare and does have a lot of legendary history behind it, especially with Shroud owning one of the most famous Fire Serpents of all time, and Shroud being one of the most famous CSGO players. This means that the Fire Serpent, with its float cap, and also with its legendary history, is going to be an interesting item to keep your eyes on. And actually, recently it has been rising quite a lot. Even the field tested condition, which isn't even related to the factory new because the field tested doesn't have a float cap, actually did rise quite a bit recently as well. I would expect the Fire Serpent to be one of the biggest gainers over this next upcoming year or two, and I think that's going to be a good idea to pick up one if you are one of those more expensive investors that's willing to put a little bit more into their investments themselves. Speaking of these items as investments, they're also very safe. Because these are rare, a lot harder to get, people aren't so focused on them, which means that the quantity is only going to get lower as more people quit the game or get trade banned, and the quantity is going to stay low, which means that the price is only going to go higher. There are a few other good options here other than just the Fire Serpent that do have float caps. For example, the M4A4 Modern Hunter, that's one that also has a 0.06 float cap, and it is a significantly rarer item in its factory new condition. This is also something I would consider picking up, especially because the M4A4 didn't get nerfed recently, and it is still competing with the lower-cost M4A1S, which means that the item is still a good item to buy, simply because a lot of people are still going to be using it in-game. Another interesting one is the FAMAS Spitfire, which does also have the float cap, and it's also a very old item. The reason this one is going to be a little bit more interesting than it usually would be is because the FAMAS recently did, of course, get a buff, and a lot more people are using it in-game. Overall, though, what I would recommend for investing in these items is just to look for ones that are on popular weapons in-game, for example, the M4A4, the AK, or whatever is a very popular item in-game, of course, and kind of look for those ones, and then figure out which ones have decent-looking skins, and could be good investments simply because of their rarity. Be warned, of course, though, these items are pretty rare because of their float cap specifically, meaning that if you buy one that doesn't have a float cap, for example, the minimal wear version of the Modern Hunter, that one's not only going to cost a lot less, but it's also not going to yield as much profit. The reason I spotlight these items is because they are rarer items, and they're older items, which means they're a lot safer than some of the newer investments that are coming out. This means that a lot of those people out there that are looking for safer investments are going to have a better chance of getting a more profit yield by buying these items. The only drawback is that they are pretty expensive because they are rare, so it's a little bit harder to get your hands on these. Going forward, I would say the best items to invest in that do have these float caps are going to be the M4A4 Modern Hunter, like I said before, the AK-47 Fire Serpent, the OP Pink DD Pat, the M4A4 Radiation Hazard, and I kind of wanted to put a Galil on this list, and the only ones that are really available in these rare factory new conditions are going to be the Galil Winter Frost, the Galil Shattered, and the Galil Orange DD Pat. For those of you that don't have as much to invest, I would recommend maybe checking out those Galils. They probably aren't going to yield as much profit simply because they are less popular, but they are going to be still pretty safe and, of course, rare because they do have the float cap. And for those of you that may inevitably ask, there are some items that can go to specific wares on the other end of the spectrum near the Battlescarred area, but I would not recommend checking out those items simply because they are going to be a little bit harder to sell and are, of course, a lot less desirable. Anyway, guys, that's going to conclude today's video. Hopefully, it was a little bit informative into this world of float capped items that some of you may not have known of. If you did enjoy the video, be sure to leave a like below, and of course, subscribe to the channel if you are enjoying the videos and want more content like this in the future. I have a lot of good videos planned in terms of investing, so if you do want the best investment tips anywhere else on YouTube, be sure to go ahead and click that subscribe button, and of course, turn on notifications so you get the information before anyone else. I do want to give a quick disclaimer that this video is sort of just an insight into an area that a lot of people may have overlooked, and it's maybe not a great suggestion for investments overall, simply because there are more recent investments that are going to be better. However, this video is going to be at the top priority for those of you that are looking for safer investments that are going to yield more profit slowly over a longer period of time. It's just simply something that I kind of realized and wanted to share with everybody out there that is maybe interested in some older, safer items that might not yield as much profit in the short term. But if you are interested in picking up these items, I do, of course, have my swap.gg link in the description below, which you can go ahead and use and check out if they have any of these items. Anyway, I really hope you guys enjoyed this video, and I'll catch you all next time. Thanks for taking time out of your day to come check out this video with me, and I will see you all later. Peace.